Today's artificial intelligence can do some extraordinary things. Its functionality, though, has very little to do with the way your brain works to achieve similar tasks. For AI to overcome its inherent limitations and advance to artificial general intelligence, we must recognize the differences between the brain and its artificial counterparts. With that in mind, this series examines the capabilities and limitations of biological neurons and how these relate to machine learning. In the first two parts of this series, we examined how a neuron's slowness makes a machine learning approach to learning implausible in neurons. And we discussed how the fundamental algorithm of the perceptron differs from a biological neuron model. Now we'll examine the fundamental architecture underlying machine learning versus that of your brain. We've all seen diagrams of the orderly layers of a machine learning neural network in which the neurons of each layer are fully connected to those in the next. In contrast, the brain appears to contain lots of disordered connections. Because it is so difficult to trace out individual connections within the brain, we don't yet know what the brain's layering structure actually is. It is obvious, though, that it is not the orderly layer-by-layer structure of machine learning. While we don't think much about how solidly perceptrons and machine learning algorithms rely on this orderly layered structure, three problems arise if we allow perceptrons to have synapses from any other in the network. First, a huge increase in the number of potential synapses. Second, the need for two-phase processing of perceptrons, or neurons. And third, backpropagation requires a constant gradient descent surface, which is not possible with potentially looping synaptic connections. In a neural network where each layer is fully connected to the next, the number of synapses increases with the square of the number of neurons in each layer. If any neuron can connect to any other, the number of possible synapses goes up with the square of the total number of neurons, a much larger number. Machine learning systems typically represent every possible synapse, and this is essential to the dramatic speedups possible with GPUs. This is necessary even though most synapses could have a zero weight and don't actually influence the operation of the network unless their weight is changed. The brain's neocortex has 16 billion neurons. With the potential for any neuron to connect to any other, this means there are 256 quintillion possible synapses. In memory, this would require 256 exabytes with only 1 byte per synapse. It's a ridiculously large number. In the brain, most of these synapses simply don't exist. The number of actual synapses is estimated at 10,000 per neuron, totaling only 160 trillion. This is a much smaller but still staggeringly large number, 160 terabytes. A huge proportion of these synapses have near zero weights. I call these synapses in waiting, which are there to store a memory by changing weight quickly should the need arise. While it's possible to structure the data so that only non-zero synapses are represented, the blistering performance improvements of today's GPUs is likely lost if we do that. Recall that the fundamental algorithm of the perceptron sums the input values from the previous layer. If we allow connections from subsequent layers, we need to differentiate between the perceptron values which have already been calculated from the previous layers and those which are yet to be calculated because they include input from subsequent layers. If the algorithm doesn't include this extension, then the perceptron values will be dependent on the order of the processing of the perceptrons. In a multi-thread implementation, this would mean that the calculated values are indeterminate. To correct this problem, the perceptron algorithm needs two phases with two internal values. There is an implementation of this two-phase algorithm in the open source Brain Simulator 2 in the file neuronbase.cpp. This is a C++ program. I suggest you check it out. The final problem of adapting a more random neuron synapse structure to machine learning is that the backpropagation algorithm can't adapt to it. The backpropagation's fundamental gradient descent relies on a stable error surface. As soon as we allow for looping connections, that surface is no longer constant over time, and the gradient descent concept breaks down. As an example, any perceptron with a synapse to itself will have a value dependent on its own previous value. The backpropagation algorithm has no way of knowing the specific value of a specific perceptron, and so it cannot appropriately adjust the surrounding synapses. In the next video in this series, I will discuss the biological neuron's limited ability to represent the precise values on which machine learning depends. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to be notified when more videos in this series are available. And for now, watch this interesting video.